You and I both love Adobe Illustrator, but how can we get the most out of this software? And we're going to start things off right here, where I'm going to hide this content with Command or Control 3 just for now. And the first thing that we can really make use of in today's tutorial is with the scale tool, which is S on your keyboard. Or of course, you can come over to here in the tool panel. Now with this tool selected, we can press enter on your keyboard, which will take us to this very nifty little panel. And you'll soon see how much potential this single panel has. Now I have a rectangle covering my entire artboard, and sometimes we want to make multiple shapes across our designs at the exact same size. So for example, I can press 25% for the horizontal number, and now my shape is exactly a quarter of my artboard or my design. I can then just hold down the Alt Option key and click and drag to duplicate this shape, before pressing Command or Control D to repeat it twice more. And if by magic, these four shapes fit exactly onto my artboard up to the edges. There are multiple ways to do this, but it's always great to know various different workarounds in software, plus the scale tool is just really great in different situations. There are a whole variety of reasons why you might want to split up your design into sections. For instance, here I'm essentially giving location and space to parts of my design, and that allows me to visualize my layout just a bit differently. And of course, with each segment being a different shape, we can now have some fun with things such as the HSB sliders. And if you ask me, these HSB sliders are pretty underrated in the design community. But here, I've selected each of the four rectangles and then holding down shift and highlighting each one as I go with a single click. But yeah, just remember that scale tool does have that kind of hidden panel which can be very useful. But now let's look at something very radically different. Have you ever tried making shadows in Illustrator, but they just end up looking miserable? Now I've got a few tricks that will certainly help you make the ugliest shadow have a sense of realism attached to it. And to demonstrate, we have here a golden hand. And firstly, we need to look at where the light is coming from on our object. And to me, it seems like it's from the left side of the design where the light source would probably be. So my shadow is probably going to point and move towards the right of my design in some kind of way. Get this wrong and your design will simply look unrealistic and just an impossible fact of nature. So let's press L for the ellipse tool and then create a shape like so. Now we're going to add a gradient, but the next few steps are very, very important. For one side of your gradient, make sure it's a dark kind of black, and I've gone for a more charcoal kind of black here as opposed to jet black. But for the opposite side of the gradient, we want to sample the background color by pressing I on your keyboard and then just sampling the color. Then heading into the color here, we can copy the hex code with Command or Control C. Now head back to the gradient and paste in the hex code into the RGB slider with Command or Control V. We want this side of the gradient to either be 0% opacity or for it just to be a low kind of percent. And that's so it blends into your design smoothly. Make sure your object is to the front of all layers and then add a Gaussian blur to your ellipse. Now you might be thinking to yourself, that's it, shadow complete. But hey, you'd be wrong. Often when working with raster effects like this in Illustrator, we have unfavorable edges like you can see at the very top edge right here. The best workaround for this is to add a feather effect which can be found up here at the top. While you're doing this, click preview and have a look at what kind of values work best for your shadow, and then when you're ready, just hit OK. The great thing about this is that we can edit the shape and even the gradient after having added the blur effect. You might even want to add a second darker blur kind of closer to the hand for extra depth. Now you might be wondering, where did you acquire that golden hand from? And well, that is the sponsor of today's video. It's something I use every single day, Envato Elements. On Envato, there are millions of resources that designers can use on their projects. And lately, I've been grabbing a bunch of resources from the 3D section. You can even just click and rotate and choose the kind of point of view you want to download, which is pretty neat. There are tons of downloads though, and for all kinds of different projects and styles, and you can be confident using them on your designs because it's a one license fits all kind of deal when you sign up to Envato. Now you can try it for 7 days totally for free, but if you don't like it after that, you can just move on with your day as usual. Now you can find that link in the description box below, but for now, let's head on to more Adobe Illustrator discoveries in today's tutorial. This next section is all about some keyboard shortcuts that few people use but which save a bunch of time. Now the first one is to send to the back, which is Shift Command Bracket, and then of course the PC variation. Now this saves just so much time, and so does the opposite of that one, which is Bring to the Front. It saves you having to come up to the object drop-down menu at the top, and during long workflows this just makes heaps of sense. So now the snake is actually behind the background layer and I can actually keep editing and manipulating it freely. And here's another nifty one. When you have a pile of objects, just hold down the command or the control key until you see this icon appear, and then you can just click, click, click until you reach the object you want to. This prevents you from moving objects around on your design to get to one kind of object, and often it is actually quicker than using the layers panel. Now here's a shortcut that I only recently started using in my workflows. We know that if you copy something and then paste it with Command or Control V, it kind of just pastes it in an annoying location. You might want to paste the object directly, exactly behind the copied version. So press Command or Control B for back. Again, the more you know, the more efficient you can be when using design software. And this one is a really neat addition to your knowledge. So the alternative, which I've been using for ages actually, is Command or Control F. And this will paste a copy directly over the top. When working in Illustrator, we want to try and be as precise as possible while saving us time. And that's exactly what these shortcuts do. And speaking of being precise, I bet you've had situations where no matter how hard you try, an object just won't snap to the edges of your artboard for whatever reason. One neat solution is to turn on the Align to Artboard button and then snap to the left edge like so. Now if I duplicate it, I can have peace of mind that it is in fact snapped to the edges of my artboard by using this function in the Align window. What do you say? Let's have some fun and make a dope background right here. Selecting both shapes, I'm going to click Make Blend, and then use the Specify Steps option with a number of 4. Then come here and choose Blend and Make. That's pretty cool, but let's move this across, press A for the direct selection tool, and then bring the blend left anchor into the center of my design. Let's use that copy command of Command Control F and paste a duplicate right in place on top. Then I'm just going to hold down Shift so I can rotate it perfectly at a 180 degree angle. And like before, instead of moving it and potentially not having it perfectly in place, we can snap it to the right edge and presto changeo, that looks pretty cool. Actually, I'm going to shift click each blend and then change the steps so that we actually get rid of these space bars between each bar. That looks pretty cool, but why stop there? Let's do something else to it. Press M for the rectangle tool and then select a dark color, preferably black. Then we're going to add a grain texture to this shape just to give the background some added intrigue and uniqueness. The final step would be to play around with the blend modes in the transparency window. And as you can see, there is a slight texture to my design right now. You can add as little or as much grain to your design, but just remember to stay precise, and one way to do that is to work in the Align window with the Artboard button highlighted. If you think you're ready for more tips, tricks, and Adobe Illustrator goodness, just click a video on screen, and until next time guys, design your future today. Peace.